Hello guys, today I'll do a quick tutorial on how to transfer a unit from one mod to another. I'm using Notepad++. Here we have DCI Last Alliance and here we have Divide and Conquer. So first thing you want to do is you want to go to the folder of the unit you want to transfer, of the mod that has the unit, and open the ADU, export the screw unit. Then you want to find the unit that you want to transfer. I already chose one, so it's gonna be this one, the Arnor Surgeons. Next thing you want to do is you want to go into your other folder, in this case the Divide and Conquer folder, and open the same file. Can move it to the other view to get them nice side by side. So here we have Divide and Conquer, here we have DCI. And you can add it wherever you want. I'll add it close to the other Northern Dunedain entries. There we go. I'm not gonna format this right now, but it's a bit differently formatted. Doesn't matter, but it just looks a bit ugly. Next thing you want to do is open the folders again. Go to the unit models folder. This is in DCI. Open battle models. And then go to divide and conquer. Again, do the same thing. Open the BMDB, that's how it's called. The battle models.modeldb. And now, what do here? First thing you will always want to check is the officer. Does it exist in the mod you're going to transfer to? So, in this case, divide and conquer. So, you can just search. No. This officer does not exist. So, what you want to do is take an officer you know does exist. Let's take a ND one and transfer it over there. Otherwise, the game is gonna crash because it's not gonna find this model. Next, you wanna look at the soldier line. Does this model exist? This is where it will take the animations from. This is not actually an entry, so. No. This also doesn't exist, so we know we need the Arno surgeons. Next, we'll need these. This will be the model and the textures. So, we go in the BMDB from DCI, we put that in, we search, and there we have it. An entry in this file goes from the name at the top all the way to where you get the string of weird numbers, which is like the position of the torch or something, I'm not sure. But this is one entry. And this is the other entry we need, that's the upgrade model. Right, you can see that in the name. So, what you want to do next is you want to click on these animations. If you don't know already, I know these exist, but search in the other BMDB and look if they exist. Okay, so this one exists. Next, that one exists. Next, that one exists. This one obviously exists. And lastly, that one exists. So this animation line, it has to exist in the opposite mode, otherwise you're gonna have a problem. These are the same, so I'm not gonna check them. So next thing you want to do is transfer this entry over to the other Battle Models database. But first, you want to see how many new entries are you gonna add? One, two, right? Because we said this is one entry. So You go to the other mods, BMDB, and you edit this number. This is the total number of entries in the mod, in the BMDB. So plus 2 is that. And now we're gonna add these entries in. You can choose any random spots, I guess. So I'll put them in right here. Yeah, that looks okay. Next, what you want to do is you'll want to find this, which is the model, the mesh, dot mesh, and you want to find these texture files. Make sure there aren't like different textures file references here, that they're all the same. So in this case, they're all the same, and the sprites as well. But you can also just copy a sprite from somewhere else in the mods BMDB that you know already exists if you don't use sprite. So anyway, so we need to go to this, textures, blah blah blah, and mounted nines upgrade 0. So that's the wrong folder, that's the divide and conquer folder. We want to look in here. So the path goes units with the underscore, this, and then mounted knight. There we go. And the other one is the upgrade one, so we're gonna copy that one as well. Now what you wanna do is in the divide and conquer folder, open that up. And make a new folder. I call it DCI. Put those in there. Make a new folder inside this DCI folder. Call it textures. And in there we're gonna copy the textures we need. So first of all, we have this for the model. So the num rock. There we go. And I'm guessing the other one is upgrade 1. Yes. We copy all of these. Put them in there. Then we have the attachment set. So in this case it's in attachment sets. So let me open it up again. So we go to unit models attachment sets, and we search for this. It's MAU upgrade 0 attach and upgrade 1. In this case, I'm not gonna put it in attachment sets here. Just to keep it nice and simple, I'm gonna put it right here in the same folder. So we have everything nice and together. And then lastly, you'll want the unit sprite, so it's Turks, Arnold, Surgeon sprite. This is just in the base data folder. Then unit sprites. And you find it. Or not. Oh, it's Arnold Surgeons, not Turk Surgeons. Copy all these files that are named that. And you transfer them over to the other mod. And it already exists, actually. So, let's skip it. So, anyway. Now that we have this folder with our textures and meshes, we are gonna look at this entry and make sure it points at this folder. So it's called DCI for us. Make sure you replace all of those. And this is still correct because we also used textures. So these paths are basically correct now. Let's do the same here. Next, what you want to do is you want to make sure this number right here has the same length as this line. You can check that in the bottom here. You see it says 52. So this needs to be 52. You don't need to add this number, or in this case the zeros, just this part is connected. So 52. Then we're gonna take this length, 51, and this length, 57. So to not waste time, I'll just copy paste these. And then in this case, we have 48. Oh, I actually made a mistake here on the path. So always watch out for that. It doesn't include the unit. So let's make sure we add that. I was thinking it looks a bit short. So 55. Then this number over here will be 60. It's usually the case if it's just a difference, norm and not norm, it's just plus 5. So we already checked all of this, that it will be compatible. So reread it, make sure it's pointing to the right folder. And it is. So we can do the same thing up here for the other one. Why is this 52 and that one 51? It's very confusing. Oh, it is actually 51. I guess I just selected the space as well. Right, it's 57. No, it's 56. Okay. Ignore the fact that I'm an idiot. Do not select space after the word, obviously. Okay, so that's correct. So 51, 56 is the same length because it's only a difference between the 1 and the 0. Same thing here. 52. Shall we transfer that over? And actually I can just do like this and change this to 0. There we go. So another thing you will maybe want to change is the fact that this unit does not have Turks as a faction entry. And we wanted to add it to the Northern Dunedain. So what you want to do in this case is just replace one of these factions or add one. If you add one, let's actually add one. If you add one, you might have to change this number. This is the amount of entries. So 5, 5. You copy one entry and you change this. So 5 Turks. Because this has 5 characters. Do it again. I already changed this to 5. And do it down here as well. So there we go. Let's have a quick scan. Make sure that everything is looking okay. 5560, 5156, 52 appear. Yeah, that looks like it's okay. So we already put the files in the folder so it can find them. So let's go over here, see what other issues we might have. Obviously we need to still transfer the Arnold Surgeons. Let's change this to Turks as well. And add slave. It's a rebel faction. We transferred these, but now there's also an important problem. This horse. You copy it, and you need to check, does this actually exist in the mod I'm going to transfer it to? To do that, you go back to data, and you open the file, the scrum mount. Hop. It does not exist, so what you want to do is transfer that over as well. So you open the other mods folder. You find that file, it's transferred over again. And here we have the entry. We copy that. Go to the divide and conquer version. And we add it in somewhere. Let's add it at the end. Now here the important thing is this. This is the model in the battle models database. So double check if it doesn't exist. It does not. So what you'll want to do is copy that over as well. So here we have the entry. Let's add that in. And we'll have to copy this file over again. So Sam will actually check quickly if this sprite exists. Where am I? And it does seem to exist, so I don't have to worry about the sprite. Okay, what I do need to worry about is these files right here. And I want to carry them over. So, let's move this over again. Let's make sure it's actually in view what we want to transfer. There we go. So the model is in mounts. Unit models. Mounts, heavy horse marker, honor horse marker. We are gonna just put it in the same folder again. So units, DCI, there we go. Please, there we go. And the other one is AR horse barred and normal. There we go. Put it in the texture folder. Now again, you want to this to lead to the right folder. So make sure the path is correct. Units, DCI, then textures. Let's copy that over. That looks fine now. And then over here, we just want units, DCI. And let's add the slash. So there we go. That's now pointing to the model. That's pointing to the textures. This animation, does it exist? Yes, it does. Go back. Okay, so now we have the horse added. We have the one thing about the horse, obviously you want to change this back to Turks as well. because you want the ND to have the unit. So yeah, there we go, as far as just adding the textures, save this, textures and models and all that stuff is concerned. But there's a bit more to adding a unit, so what else do we need? You'll need the text entry, so go over in the folder you took the unit from, and you open export unit, and let's do the same thing in divide and conquer. Text, export unit, look at its dictionary name, copy that, find it, there we go. And you basically just copy this entry and paste it in somewhere. Doesn't really matter where you do it, I'll just do it in a random spot for now. There we go. So now we have made sure the description and the name is there. If it's not there, the game will crash immediately. So to finish up, we need the unit cards, which in this case will be in the Sicily folder because it was a condo unit. So we go to UI, units, Sicily. On a surgeon. So again, UI, units, in this case we'll put it in Turks. There we go. On a surgeons, I want to do the same for the unit info, that's a picture in the description above it. So we go again to the Turks folder, and here to the Turks folder. And you can transfer it over. Okay, for deck, it's actually better because it's campaign focus also added to the slave folder. So if it goes slave, it can still have the right pictures. So let me do that real quick. So there we go. We added the UI, we added the unit, we added the mount entry. So the last thing is we need to add this model so it can get the right animations. So let's make 100% sure this doesn't exist in deck already. Nope. Okay. So let's find the entry. There we go. This little entry over here. You can also switch it with another unit in the target mod that you know has the same animations, but that might be a bit more complicated, so I'll just do it this way for now. Let's fix the paths again. Did we actually fix it over here? Oh. I'm a bit all over the place, but that's how we usually work, and the entity will work. You can trust me on that. Okay, so we have this new model added, the Honor Sergeant. So let's switch this all up to the right paths. So it's honor.texture, honor normal, and arms.ld0. And it already has Turks entries. So let's make sure that these actually exist in these paths that we are pointing it to. So Here we'll be able to find it in this folder again. And then divide and conquer, we'll put it in our DCI folders. So it was called arms, this one, I assume. Yeah, there we go. And textures honor.texture and honor_normal.texture. And then go back to unit models, attachment sets, and copy honor_div and honor_norm. There we go, we have everything in one folder. As is pointed to here. So, fix the paths. 45, 37, 52. So this one is also 51, yeah, the same length. There we go. We added that unit as well, so now it won't crash when we reference it in the ADU. We made sure all these exist, we fixed these paths. Did I do this part for the horse actually? Yes. Always double check. It'll save you some time restarting the game, figuring out what's going on. But it looks like I did everything correctly. Or maybe not, 50. So yeah, I keep getting these spaces, so. So that's correct. That's correct. Okay, everything's correct. So that should be all you need to successfully start the game. One other thing you usually want to look at is the stats. For example, this is the general's unit, we don't want that. We already have a bodyguard in this faction. What else do we have? You can just look at the straight up stats as well. I don't know what unit this is, what kind of unit. But I think it's a mid-tier kind of elite cav, so maybe I'll give it like Dunedain cavalry stats. It's good to take stats from the target mod you're gonna put it in instead of just using the stats from the mod you copied from, because every mod has its own balancing. Like for example, this is actually pretty insane defensive stats in deck. It's actually identical to these other than knights. So maybe I'll keep it that way, but I see they have way higher morale. So let's pump the morale up a bit to make them more in line. These recruitment times, let's just copy the other knights for now. I don't know what's up with these armor upgrade levels. I didn't know you can do that. So yeah, let's just make them a bit more normal. Or if you want to make it more like other units, you can just do this. That's just for this mod with the triple boost. So there we go. Now it's stat-wise, it looks more like a deck unit as well. Camel minus 4. Yeah, other units use stuff like that as well, should be fine. I think tech generally doesn't punish it that much. We don't need this knight attribute. Yeah, I think that's fine. So let's see if we can get it to run in game. Let's see. I have no idea what I'm looking for. I don't know what the unit guard looks like. I think it's these guys. Yeah, there we go. The Sojons Rokwen. Make sure it actually runs, doesn't have any problems. By the way, I ran the full cleaner before, and that is actually a requirement. And here you see the unit works perfectly fine. Doesn't have any silver surfers or anything like that, so that's fine. If you look at the stats, the picture is working, description, it's unit stats. So yeah, everything looks to be fine. Yeah, about the full cleaner thing. So if you make changes to any of the text files, these .bin files need to be deleted. Otherwise your changes won't take change. So you can either do that manually, or Divide and Conquer has this file called Full Cleaner, which automatically deletes everything for you. So yeah, so that's a requirement if you change something in the text files or some other files, because it deletes map.rwm as well. So yeah, that's it basically. We got our unit working. One more thing you can potentially do is you have these lines right here. Remove all of that. If you put here, for example, the directories to Turks, you won't have to add unit and info cards to every single folder you want the unit to have. It will just always look in that folder for the unit. Another problem you might run into is if it has the mercenary unit attribute, then it needs to here have a merc entry. Otherwise, it will be a silver surfer. And yeah, that's it basically. Thanks for watching, and I hope it helped you transfer unit between mods. Actually, one more quick note. I added two more entries, the horse and the honor surgeons, so I forgot to change this. Also, let's close the game. If you want to add the unit to a building, you open the extra discrete buildings. You go down to the building you want to add it to. So we have the stables, it's both castle and city, so you need to add it to both. And to every level, normally. But for now, I'll just show you how to add one entry, so let's copy one. Go back here, copy the name. sure that's the same name. And here's the starting pool, the replenishment rate, and how much does it end. So this would be a little fast. You can look at all the similar units and see. But yeah, basically when this reaches 1, then a unit will become available. So 1 divided by this is the amount of turns. Requires factions, in our case it's Turks. And region religion, in our case it's Islam. 33 in this case. You can add other requirements as well, but for now let's just do this. So this is how you would make it recruitable in your campaign in a building. So you add this here, you add this to all the other levels, and then you add it also to the city version. That was just the castle version. So you would add again here and here and here. So yeah. So yeah, thanks for watching this time for real, and bye bye.